ABC News. Monday, an ABC News investigation. Some FBI surveillance operations may be classifying peaceful demonstrators as terrorists. Watch ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
Coming up on Action News, a stampede after a concert in Nashville leaves two teenagers dead. Congressional lawmakers are one step closer to passing the budget. And Christmas shoppers seem to be going over their budget this year.
And I'm Nelson Robinson. It looks as though George is in the suit for the day, at least. I'll have details a little later in the newscast.
All right, those stories and much more coming up next on Channel 2 Action News.
I'm up to my towel in Oldsmobiles. I've got to sell them.
Hey, get to Maxi Price Chevrolet Oldsmobile Monroe and choose from a complete inventory of beautiful 1988 Oldsmobiles.
Mr. Price, there's nothing to cry about. We're just going bowling. Would you care to go?
No, thanks. You go ahead and have fun.
Maxi Price, Chevrolet Oldsmobile, Monroe, Georgia.
It's here, season savings at Menswear Outlet on Witte Brothers dress shirts, Henry Grethel sport shirts, Botany 500 slacks, McGregor sweaters, all for $9.90 each at Menswear Outlet.
From WSB-TV, Atlanta, Georgia's news leader. This is Channel 2's Action News with Patrick Crosby, Nelson Robinson Weather, and the Channel 2 Action News team.
The sudden rush of a concert crowd ends in the deaths of two teenagers, a couple dozen more injured in a scene of panic in Tennessee. And that is our top story. Good afternoon. I'm Patrick Crosby. It has happened before in other cities, the concert crowd that is frightened or panicked in a closed, confined area. That was the case again last night, just after a rap concert in Nashville. The two people were literally crushed to death after concertgoers jammed in the basement of a hall where there was to be an after-concert Christmas party. A security guard said someone set off fireworks in the middle of the confined crowd. Others thought it was a gun. Police say the crush also set off a number of fights. A total of 23 were injured. As in other fatal concert-related tragedies, security and concert organizers are bracing for possible lawsuits. In Washington, on Capitol Hill, lawmakers may vote this afternoon on a 24-hour stopgap spending package that will keep our government running tomorrow. Pam Olson reports lawmakers managed to remove one major obstacle last night.
The compromise came nearly a week after negotiations began. At stake is the $600 billion which is needed to finance the federal government for fiscal year 1988.
We have reached an agreement in principle, subject to looking at it in paper.
And subject to presenting it to our leadership and checking it with the president.
Exactly.
But we think we're fairly close together, and I'm going home to go to sleep thinking the country issue is settled.
We've made a lot of progress.
The deal would allow $3.6 million in food, clothing, shelter, and medicine to the Contras. $4.5 million would be allocated for the cost of getting it to them. On Friday night, the Senate's offer was $9 million, the Democrats' $5.5. The White House originally wanted $22.8, but part of the deal negotiated includes the delivery of previously purchased weapons, which is opposed by many House Democrats. In this plan, military aid already approved could be delivered for the first 12 days of 1988. Delivery would cease for at least a week while progress is reviewed in peace talks. If no ceasefire is in place, military aid could begin again, but only until February 4th. Both the House and Senate would be required to approve the continuation of any weapons aid.
I think it is, but I always hold out some reservations when you're dealing with this many different people.
President Reagan had vowed to veto the spending bill unless it included aid to the Contras. He renewed his request for the aid in his regular Saturday broadcast.
The compromise must still be approved by President Reagan and congressional leaders on Sunday before it ever reaches the floor of the House and Senate. Meanwhile, the U.S. government has run out of money, and the effects will be felt Monday morning unless another temporary spending bill is passed by Congress this weekend.
And members of Congress aren't the only ones having fiscal problems this Christmas season. Consumers are having problems staying within their budgets.
Even with Christmas sales soft in the nation's stores, consumers are still hard on their credit cards. Consumer credit debt is at its highest level ever. And now some stores, like the Broadway store in Los Angeles, are offering quickie credit. Walk in with two forms of ID and walk out with an account, a credit line, and Christmas gifts. Experts say shoppers are walking a fine line, balancing the buy-it-all attitude of a pre-crashed bull market with the austere reality of a less merry Christmas. Stephen Roach is senior economist with Morgan Stanley.
Now, it's one thing for levels of indebtedness to rise during the face of a roaring bull market, but when that market turns, the level of comfort afforded to American consumers begins to ebb and ebb very sharply.
But the crush to provide a Christmas like the ones of recent years can sweep shoppers into something they know they shouldn't do.
I can use my credit card too much. I have, and I probably will again.
Yeah, I think they're just about up to the limit.
Americans now spend an unprecedented 20% of their take-home pay to service debt other than their mortgages. Even American Express, which asks for full payment each month, has seen levels of purchases and card acquisitions greater than ever before. Amex likes to think people are forcing prudence on themselves by using a card that doesn't provide for time payments.
Well, we believe that the card member uses the card as a tool for financial discipline, and we believe that that's one of the reasons that during the fourth quarter of this year, our retail spending on the card has been very, very strong.
Experts say shoppers from Atlanta to Los Angeles also have less savings in the bank than ever before. So even as consumers disdain the burden of credit card debt, they can only go along with it since there's less money in the bank to pay cash.
Coming up on Action News this noon, violence in Israel may force cancellation of Christmas activities in Bethlehem. Stay with us.
Next, owners of a bicycle shop get sued.
We've sold bikes to people that are 300 pounds before.
On the next, People's Court.
That's Monday at 5 on Channel 2.
America's talking about Geraldo. Geraldo Rivera is hot.
If you want to know about, let me talk, you ask me a question.
Success of Geraldo is welcome news.
Racial incident, yes or no, Bo?
In Howard Beach? No.
Geraldo, you never know what to expect.
The latest scoops on Liz Taylor, Cher, Michael Douglas, and more. Hot gossip for the soaps, too, on the next Geraldo.
Geraldo, Monday morning at 9, here on Channel 2. Joyous holiday season. Everyone at King Springs Village Retirement Community would like to wish you and yours a holiday filled with peace, love, and happiness.
We interrupt this cold to bring you this important message. Introducing new NyQuil Cherry flavor. Now people of all tastes can relieve their colds at night. New NyQuil Cherry flavor. NyQuil Relief. Cherry taste.
In Channel 2's Worldview this afternoon, the heaviest fighting in as much as a decade has broken out in the Gaza Strip of Israel. The violence in the streets in Israeli-occupied territories has continued to spread. The battles may end up canceling some Christmas activities planned in Bethlehem, the West Bank town known as the birthplace of Jesus. 13 straight bloody days of violence. The Egyptian government has been severely criticized what it calls Israeli police brutal treatment of Palestinians while breaking up that rioting. Authorities in Alabama are mourning the deaths of two police officers and two citizens in the small town of Ozark, Alabama. The two officers were gunned down when they responded to a domestic call and were trying to help a wounded man lying in front of the house. SWAT teams tried waiting out the gunman inside. After 6 hours, they stormed the house and found that the gunman had taken his own life. The jury in the Howard Beach assault trial is now into its 11th day of deliberations and still no verdict in New York. Defense attorneys in the case of alleged racially motivated murder say they are unhappy with what they call inconsistent judges' rulings on what the jury can and can't consider in their deliberations. Well, still ahead this afternoon, Mr. Food has some tips for holiday teetotalers.
And it looks as though the wet stuff will be with us through the day and the first part of tomorrow. I'll have details in the forecast coming up.
Masterpiece with your name on it waiting to be created at Sizzler's incredible all-you-can-eat tostada and salad bar.
Sizzler.
Circuit City has so many wonderful electronic things all under one roof, it's hard not to get distracted.
I'm here to buy a calculator, and that's all. No browsing, no touching.
Circuit City can really test your self-control.
Very nice. But it's not a calculator. It's not a calculator.
The most up-to-date selection of brand names, all at Circuit City's guaranteed low prices.
So how could I resist?
Circuit City.
Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!
This is the enemy for every individual who suffers hair loss. This is the battlefield where hundreds of apparently healthy hairs are lost each day. The cause may be poor nutrition, sebaceous buildup, stress, or heredity. The Hair and Scalp Clinic of Atlanta can analyze your hair loss problem and recommend a treatment program that will stimulate growth. Operators are standing by now. Call 261-2608 for a free brochure or surrender to the enemy.
Well, have you gotten those phone calls from your relatives up north yet saying, I hear it's going to be 60 down in Georgia and down south. I hear it's going to be 60s and 50s.
Yeah, exactly. We've got some areas of South Georgia today may get over the 70-degree mark once again today. Nice warm night last night, but wet.
Yeah.
And that'll be with us for a while. Let's take a look at our current conditions. We've got a good bit of the soup, which we'll have to deal with in the next 36 hours. 60 degrees at this hour. Under cloudy light rain falling in Atlanta, humidity at 97%, the wind is from the west at 10, which gives an indication that a weak cool front's moving through the area, and the barometer, 30.12 inches of mercury and steady. Yesterday's high was, 60 degrees? Morning low 54, record high 72 dates back to 1984, the record low 9 degrees dates back to 1981, and since midnight we've had 12 one-hundredths of an inch of rain. We'll expect a little more in the bucket during the day today. Sunrise tomorrow and sunset this evening at the bottom of your screen. Channel 2 MetNet and temperatures around Georgia haven't moderated much in the last or overnight. 51 degrees at the present time at Clayton, 59 at Dalton, 56 at Jasper, 55 up at Rome, 61 degrees at Roswell, and 60 degrees down at Griffin. Now, we'll take a look at Channel 2 Action Radar. You can see that we do have some light shower activity around the region. For the most part, this is ground clutter, a false echo inside the perimeter. That's all the buildings and the like around the area. Rainfall is somewhat light, and it is falling around much of Georgia, but for the because it's so light, we're having problems detecting it on our radar. As we take a look at the satellite picture, though, you can see all the cloud cover, which is kind of converged around Georgia and the southeastern portion of the country. There is a dry slot working through northern Mississippi and Alabama, which may bring a little sunshine a little later this morning to portions of northwestern Georgia, but it will be brief. We've got a strong southwesterly wind flow aloft, and some of that strong winds actually work all the way down to the lower levels at about 5,000 feet above the surface, so the clouds will roll in rapidly. We're looking at shower activity, which is more numerous, or will be a little bit later this afternoon toward our south. There's a weak cool front kind of moving through the Atlanta metro area right now. We kind of converge with this drier, cooler air, which is sending back through the middle Mississippi Valley, and that will kind of work together and slowly work off toward the southeast, and with that, a chance of thunderstorms or possibly a thundershower, a thunderstorm or two down in the southern areas and southern counties of the state later this afternoon and tonight. This area of high pressure back through, which is centered over Oklahoma and Kansas, will begin to dominate our weather actually on Tuesday. As we take a look at the national radar summary, the heaviest activity is up around a weak low pressure area or a system which is weakening as it moves toward the northeast. They've had a lot of problems overnight with winter storm warnings, freezing rain, snow, and the like through a good portion of western New York and Lake Erie and around Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Heavier showers along the coast. Activity seems to be somewhat light, but it is rather widespread across the Gulf Coast. It's just so light that radars aren't detecting it. Tomorrow, we'll look for the cool front to slowly glide toward the coastal area, and with that, a little overrunning will persist in the northern portion of the state, as we'll look for a wind shift later tonight and the first part of tomorrow. The clouds will be slow to retreat as this air is somewhat shallow, kind of laying over the northern portion of the state. But eventually it will work off, and with that the clouds will begin to break on late Monday and certainly by Tuesday morning. As we take a look at temperatures today, somewhat balmy around Georgia. 70 degrees will be seen in many areas from, the southern half of the state. Look at Florida. What a Christmas, huh? 82 degrees expected down at Fort Lauderdale later this afternoon, while quite cold back up through the central and high plains toward the Pacific Northwest. Our high today, 64 degrees, rain chances at 50%, but look at the winds out south-southwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. And with that, we'll be looking for rain around the region to race off toward the northeast at about 40, 45 miles per hour. Take a look at the five-day, we will see some breaks. It will begin to appear actually Monday afternoon, and certainly by Tuesday, a rather nice day. As temperatures get back down to seasonable norms, we will be looking for a slight warm-up, though, as the approach of the next weather system on Thursday will bring a slight chance of showers.
Yeah, but that's very warm. You can almost hear the cars coming down 75 now for the holidays, seeing those temperatures. That's great. Thanks very much, Nelson. Mm-hmm. Well, still ahead, TV personalities try to make a holiday splash at the movies.
Vintage Lighting, with North Atlanta's very best selection of table and floor lamps, chandeliers, and outdoor lighting, wishes you and your family the brightest of holidays and a prosperous new year.
Great party. The guy's loaded. You know, it's a good-looking tux.
It ought to be. Custom-made, $400.
Really?
It's not a bad tux either.
Zeman Manufacturing, $99. They've got their own factory.
You gotta be kidding.
Zeman Manufacturing. Because in life, stuff happens.
Mom's magic meatloaf is weighing on you like a ton of bricks. Send the bubbles of Alka-Seltzer to the rescue, because speed is what you need to lift the heaviness off your stomach and relieve your heartburn and pounding headache fast. So for fast relief, let the bubbles rise to the occasion.
Alka-Seltzer to the rescue.
Try extra strength Alka-Seltzer. More of what you take Alka-Seltzer for.
Special interest groups and law enforcement officials are grimly predicting there will be more drunk driving problems these next two holiday weeks. But there is a definite trend towards non-drinking. Even Mr. Food steps away from the stove with a few non-alcoholic tips.
All over the country today, there's a big push by the restaurants to come up with some new, good-looking, good-tasting drinks without using any alcoholic beverages in them. Well, with the new driving laws and insurance rates and the general caring for the people. All the magazines and newspapers and trade journals coming up with creative ideas for non-alcoholic fun drinks that look festive. A lot of companies are doing the in thing by creating recipes to use their products without the alcohol. Fruit drinks, especially festive looking. So they're getting a bigger play right now at the markets. Just a whirl in the blender and you've got a frosty fruit drink that'll put you on a white sand beach with whatever color you look best with. And the garnishes can let you be as creative as you want on that beach. Fruit punches, nogs, naturally festive. At one time, if you didn't over-imbibe a little bit, people would make fun of you and snicker. Today, people are realizing that moderation might be a better guideline. And if you're driving, a definite no-no. But what about sociability? Well, those new creations are awfully nice looking to start with at a party. And so are a lot of the new delicious non-alcoholic grape juices. The bottles look just like wine bottles. There's the non-bubbly kinds and the really, really festive bubbly ones. Now that looks holiday all the way. They come in a lot of the same grape varieties as regular wine and a lot of brands. So your tastes can be happy. And your image is really in. Know what else is in? Being able to say tomorrow, ooh, it's so good.
That's a pretty good thought. That's nice. Among the plethora of films that have come out for the holiday season after you've drunk all that non-alcoholic stuff that Mr. Food was pushing are two comedies featuring well-known TV personalities. Joe Lovett looks at Throw Mama from the Train and Leonard, Part 6.
As black comedies go, you probably couldn't find a better title for one than the new Danny DeVito, Billy Crystal film, Throw Mama from the Train. In it, DeVito sets out to kill Crystal's wife, who took his best-selling novel and put her name on it. In return, he expects Crystal to kill his mama, the most unpleasant, overbearing villain in movies since Darth Vader, brilliantly played by Anne Ramsey. That plot sounds black and untraditional enough, but you know it misses the mark when its most inspired laugh is a piece of very traditional slapstick.
Who's this?
This is Cousin Patty.
You don't have a Cousin Patty.
You lied to me!
It also says something when the black comedy elements are overshadowed by the nice quiet touches, like when DeVito talks about his late father. He does a fine job directing here, but Crystal is stuck in the thankless role of the author who does little more than stumble around saying he can't believe he's in this situation, he can never kill another human being, etc., etc. Some bright spots, including an unforgettable scene with a trumpet, make this one a close call. But Throw Mama from the Train earns only 2.5 popcorn boxes out of a possible 4. That's disappointing, but it's not half as disappointing as this year's official Christmas turkey. Leonard Part 6 is TV Superman Bill Cosby's return to feature films, and it's enough to make one wish he hadn't come back. It's a spoof of James Bond and sequel, since there was no Leonard Parts 1 through 5. Kaz is a retired secret agent coming out of retirement to save the world from an evil villainous and renegade lobsters. Now, to be honest, the first 15 minutes of this film, which includes a kitchen shootout, are hilarious. But it's downhill from there, overwhelmed by special effects and gadgetry and underwhelmed by Cosby's totally lifeless performance. He's been more dynamic in pudding commercials, and he came up with the story and produced this mess. Perhaps the most infuriating thing about Leonard Part 6 is that Coca-Cola shows up so prominently it should have been listed in the credits as a co-star. Columbia Pictures, who is owned by, you guessed it, Coca-Cola, should be ashamed of this kind of huckstering. But they'll get theirs once this film is released. Pepsi stock should go right through the roof. Leonard Part 6, however, goes nowhere, earning only one popcorn box out of a possible four. At the screening I attended, a little girl behind me said, "Mommy, I wish this was over." From the mouths of babes. Joe Lovett, ABC News.
Well, still ahead, Ernie Johnson with sports highlights this weekend. And we'll listen in as some kids tell Santa what they want for Christmas this year.
Wow. I'm glad we made that one.
And Daddy, what are you doing?
I'm writing a check to Mercy University.
Why?
Because quality education requires a financial commitment from all of us.
Granddad, that's the best check to write.
You too can be a part of the Mercer campaign. Make your best check to Mercer today.
Keep the memories flowing. Melt away the miles. You can hear the laughter. You can almost see the smiles. Oh, hello, everyone. You've got so much to tell. Hello, everyone. This is Southern Bell.
Isn't there someone special you'd like to call?
It's here. Spectacular season savings at Menswear Outlet's outstanding Christmas sale. Famous Witte Brothers all-wool suits, now $99. Shetland sport coats in the season's most wanted styles and colors, now $49. Witte Brothers dress shirts, only $9.90. Henry Grethel sport shirts, just $9.90. Botany 500 dress lacs, only $9.90. And McGregor sweaters, all for just $9.90 each. Celebrate spectacular season savings at Menswear Outlet. Hurry before it's over.
Well, in sports, it was a very important day for some Georgia high schools yesterday, and even the pros had a couple of games. With that and more, here's Ernie Johnson.
All right, state titles on the line last night in high school football. Our Phil Van Horn took in the Quad A championship game at jam-packed Terra Stadium as Morrow met Effingham County.
About 14,000, standing room only, witnessing the first 4A title game in suburban Atlanta this decade. Number 11, Jeff Howard, largely responsible for Morrow making it to the title game. A teammate responsible for the result once there. Pick it up early first quarter. Howard to fullback Ray Doran. 14 yards, lunging in. Mustangs scoring on their first possession. Move late third period, still 7-0. Doran busting through the line, picking up steam and looking for a block downfield. Ray Doran streaking 89 yards, and it's 14-0. Now fourth quarter, Effingham County abandoning the wishbone. Paul Sumner looking deep. Danny Williams intercepting, returning to the 32-yard line. Then Doran, the senior, capping it off. Doran bowling in. Final, 21-0. Morrow shutting down the Rebels.
It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. God, I'm glad I can end my career like this.
3 weeks ago, this Mustang team won the region title and assured itself a spot as the best in Morrow High School history. With a win tonight, now they can claim that they are the best in the 4A division.
And the rest of the high school playoff scores are coming in!
All right, nice going Mustangs. They win by shutout in AAA. Worth County, the champions, 26-15 winners over Marist in AA. Central of Carrollton, a 28-7 winner over R.E. Lee. And the Class A champion, Lincoln County, 19-14 winners over Brookstone. At the Omni last night, Hawks trying to climb into a virtual tie for first in the Central with Detroit, the Utah Jazz in town. And what a ball game they had last night. Season high 46 for Dominique. That jam gave him a one-point lead at the half, but Utah got an incredible night off the bench from Daryl Griffith. He was lighting it up, 32 points hitting from all over the floor. And Utah had a 6-point lead going to the fourth quarter. Their lead was cut to 2. Under 30 seconds, Karl Malone, the mailman, delivers. Jazz by 4. The lead was 3 with just 1 second left. That's enough time for John Battle. 3-pointer at the buzzer. We are going to overtime. Hawks and Jazz all tied up. And Dominique caps it off, giving the Hawks the lead for good with a tip slam. Hawks in overtime win it 130-124. In college hoops, Georgia Tech went to 6-1 yesterday at the Palestra in Philadelphia. Tommy Hammond sat this one out with a bum leg, but he really wasn't missed against Penn. Dwayne Farrell led the Jackets with 22 and a 79-55 thrashing. Michael Christian added 14 for Tech. Dennis Scott right there at a big night against LSU, but was held to just 9 yesterday. But Tech an easy winner by 24 over Penn. Meantime, Georgia's Bulldogs hammered Alabama-Birmingham in that holiday tournament in Tokyo. 85-66 was the final as Tony Mack scored 26. College football last night, the site, Shreveport, Louisiana, as the Independence Bowl was played. Mack Brown coaching his Tulane finale. He'll take over at North Carolina next year. The Green Wave matched up against Washington in the Independence Bowl. And here's the Huskies' Daryl Franklin. Nice catch in the back of the end zone for the score. Washington rolls to a 24-12 win over Tulane. In the NFL, Kansas City's Nick Lowry trying to send the Chiefs into overtime against Denver, but his 37-yarder is just wide. Broncos win it 20-17. It is head-hanging time for the KC faithful. Denver inches closer to a playoff berth in the AFC. They need a win over, one more win or a loss by Cleveland, San Diego, Pittsburgh, or Seattle. NFC, the Giants beat the Packers 20-10 and knocked Green Bay out of the NFC playoff picture. 20-10, the Giants win it. And, of course, this afternoon, it's the Falcons with Chris Miller starting at quarterback, taking on the Niners in San Francisco at 4 o'clock this afternoon. We'll have first half highlights of that one at 6 o'clock. And we leave you now with all the NBA and college basketball scores from last night.
There is one man who is working a lot of long hours this holiday season. He is, of course, Santa Claus. Channel 2's Joyce Oscar caught up with him at Cumberland Mall and has this exclusive interview.
Yes, amen.
His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. Bouncing children on his knee and listening to toy lists that would make anyone weary.
A bubble gum machine, a feed me game, Ghostbusters, Donkey Tongue. The Ghostbusters, station wagon, a power wagon.
The race car, I wanted, not just a race car that you just do by hand. I wanted that you drive.
That you drive?
Yeah.
A what?
A race car.
A race car. Why would you want a race car?
He's a tomboy.
His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow.
I forgot to tell you about my stove.
You did?
Yeah.
You want a stove in your kitchen?
Yeah.
You better hurry. Oh, he lost his nerve. Yeah. That make it better? How you doing?
How you doing, Sam?
Just fine.
Oh, I hope you're able to pass
it. I hope I'm not going to break your leg. Am I?
And I heard him exclaim as we drove out of sight.
You have a merry, merry Christmas, all right?
And to all, a good night. Joyce Oscar, Channel 2 Action News.
Boy, that was nice, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was terrific. Well, listen, that'll do it for us at noon. Hope you have a good weekend. See you.
See what happens when Mary Tyler Moore goes from funny lady to first lady with leading man Sam Waterston on the next Entertainment Tonight.
That's Monday at 7:30 on Channel 2. Take a tip from Santa's helper and clean up your last-minute Christmas shopping with Turbo Wash, the American way to keep...